Hey YouTubers. So this will be the last T4D that I do from this lab. You will note there will be another T4D which I did some time ago on the license upgrade to my Agilent oscilloscope. So there will be another one that you'll see, but that's been previously recorded. I've got a few videos which have been recorded which are there as a buffer because we are literally a week away from packing up home and the lab and moving to our new home, and then obviously I need to set up everything again. So I'm going to have a few videos buffered in there. There won't be any tutorials. I need time to prepare those. So there's going to be a T4D on the upgrade to my Agilent oscilloscope. I did the repair on my electronic DC load, so there's a video on that. There'll be quick tech videos on some equipment that's arrived. I'll just highlight that. So the one piece, and I mentioned this in I think the video that I did on the electronic DC load, it's the Velaman HPS-140i. So it's one of these mini portable handheld oscilloscopes. I imagine that for the most part, most people aren't going to want this, but they're fairly cheap. It's about $132. So I thought I'd just get one just to see if it is worth anything at all. So I'll do a quick review on that and see what it's like. What I'm also going to do then is like the pyramid generator, which can be used for checking the calibration of your oscilloscopes. I'll do a quick tech review on that as well. Now, in terms of the quick tech videos, so the first one is already out there, and it seems that for the most part, people do enjoy the format, but they're saying, please, we obviously want the longer format. So as I said, the quick tech videos aren't extra. So it's just there to appease the folks who do want a quick intro into equipment. They don't want to have to sit through a 20-40 minute video. Also, what it means is like equipment like this, which I've got on the shelves here, which I just haven't had time to do full reviews of, I can do quick videos of these, so at least you get some idea of what it's about. And then if people really want to see a full review, a more in-depth review on one of those items which are in a quick tech video, I'll then go ahead and do that. I will, as a matter of course, for a fair amount of the equipment that I do in the quick tech videos, I will do full reviews because I would have done that anyway. But there might be some items which, as I say, might not necessarily make it to a full review, but you can request that. And if there's enough interest, then obviously I'll do a full review on that equipment. The T4D formats will basically stay the same. And of course, obviously the tutorials will be in the normal format that I do. Right, so as I said, we're in the state of packing up. It's Monday today, and literally Wednesday next week is the day that we will be moving. I've gone and purchased a fair bit more equipment for the lab. I've got another one of these benches, so I'll have three benches which will provide me with more space. The basement area is obviously a lot larger than I've got now, so I'm really looking forward to that. I'm not going to consume all of it. I'm going to have a kind of relaxed area at the end of it so that the family do have a little bit of space in the basement as well, but I will certainly gain a lot more space. I've also gone and bought some extra lighting equipment, so I'm hoping to improve the lighting, and I'm going to invest in an additional camera. So I know some people have been asking questions about what cameras I use, and just for fun today, I've got my second camera kind of up to the side doing a side shot so you can get the kind of behind the scenes look of what goes on. But I've got two cameras, and the one I talk to is a Canon, and the other one on the side which I use for the equipment reviews on the bench is a Sony. Now the interesting fact is that the Canon I bought as an upgrade to the Sony, but there are a few things that weren't quite right with the Canon. First of all, it did have a bigger sensor, so it meant that under lower light conditions, you have a better picture. It doesn't have a wide angle lens like the Sony has, and that I wasn't fully aware of when I purchased it. So that means when I've got it on the bench, I'd have to have it far higher in the air to kind of get the same view as I do with the Sony. So that's a problem. At least the Sony, I can have it at eye height and still get the viewing angle that I need on the bench. And the Sony's autofocus coming in for close-ups is far better. The Canon seems to struggle. So what I'm going to be moving to is a fair bit more expensive Sony, again with a wide angle, a nice big big sensor, bigger than the actual Canon has got. That'll help for those shots where the lighting isn't as good. It doesn't get as noisy or as grainy in the picture. And I'm starting to upload full HD now. So I'm going for 1080p as opposed to just the 720p, because I want the high resolution up there, because it's something that people are starting to demand. I mean, even myself, now that I'm kind of cutting the link to cable, when I go watch things on Roku, I want to see them in high definition. And if you've got a nice big LCD TV, it's nice to have the nice higher resolution so you get a nice big picture on those TVs. So that's something I'm going to be doing as well. So bear with me over these next few weeks. I'm not going to do a video of the breakdown of this lab. There are so many other videos I want to fit in that I just don't have the time to fit that in as well. But what I will do is I will do a video of the kind of bare bones setup in the basement in the new home next week. And then obviously I'll give you a full tour once I've got the whole lab set up and everything up and running. A lot of this is also to the reason I'm in particular trying to upgrade my lab and have better lighting and better camera, is that I will potentially be doing videos outside of YouTube. So I might be doing some videos for a company outside of YouTube, some technical videos. And for that, I want good video quality. They also need to be shorter, which is another good reason why I'm obviously practicing those shorter videos for the quick tech videos. I also plan to soon do a video explaining the ins and outs, probably towards the end of the year, kind of a wrap up at the end of the year, because it will be 2 full years that I've been doing this full time. It's been a challenging 2 years, as I will explain, because obviously the one was just trying to get to a point where this would generate enough income to make it viable, and then two, changing continents and moving again, has been a fair bit of turmoil in these last 2 years. So I'll kind of wrap up and explain all that, and then also go into the detail and challenges of doing this full time. I've certainly realized, I thought if you'd asked me about 8 months ago whether you could grab a camera and start producing videos and start making money off YouTube, I'd have said yes, it's very doable. But now I'm beginning to realize that if I had to start doing what I'm doing now and try to make a living out of it, it would be a huge challenge. There are so many people who are in this space now trying to create videos to get their videos, hit good search results, get good viewership, subscriptions and views. So it has become far more difficult. So I count myself very fortunate at where I am, but I'll go into the details of how many videos you need, what kind of viewership and the number of views to try and make a living out of this. It certainly is challenging, and I certainly couldn't do it I could only just about do it off the YouTube income. I certainly need other incomes outside of YouTube for good reason. I want to diversify. If anything happened to the YouTube income because they changed their policies or something like that, at least I've got another income stream. And hence, that's why, let's say, the sponsorship through tesla.co.uk, having Paolo there, and now perhaps another income stream by doing videos for a company, that at least provides some redundancy so that I can keep doing what I enjoy doing. But anyway, so there's a lot happening in these next few weeks, a fair bit of chaos, but I'll keep you up to date as best I can. I have just seen comments on one of the quick tech video. Someone has said, thank heavens in less polite terms, thank heavens I got rid of the intro music. So at the moment, I spent 20 minutes creating that new intro to the quick tech video. So I didn't take much time to do it. I just needed to literally throw something together. I will, as time allows, kind of improve on that. Now, at the moment, I'm still using the old music on these videos. So give me a vote. Let me know. Would you like me to change the intro music would you like me to change all my intro music to the one that I used on that quick tech video? If that's the case, then let me know. Or if some of you want to stick with this old music, then also let me know. I'll make a decision and then perhaps blanket use the newer music across all the videos. Now, the one handy thing about the music, those of you who've been following my channel long enough will know that there have been loads of challenges with music. YouTube have an algorithm which strictly check for copyright, and I've had issues where I've not used copyright music, but their algorithm has still picked it up and I've had to take down videos, strip the music and upload them without and what have you. YouTube have now kindly provided their creators with a library of music which is created so you can specifically download it and use it and edit it and use it in your video. So that's where that music came from. So it is supposedly safe to use, and it seems so far. So at least there is potentially a little more variety for intro music. That is all the news to date. I say I'm plugging away at just getting the last few videos created this week of bits and pieces which are coming into the lab. The one last bit which I forgot to mention, I have got an analog oscilloscope coming in, which I'm really looking forward to getting. It's a brand new one, it's not an older one. I do plan to get some older analog oscilloscopes down the line as well, but I think there's a lot to be learnt and gained from having a nice simple analog scope. But we'll see. Again, I'll do a quick video review on it, and then if people are keen, I'll do a proper more in-depth review later down the line. But anyway, thanks very much for watching, and I'll catch you soon for the next one. Cheers.